हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ आदिल हुसैन शेख, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑटोमोबाइल डिपार्टमेंट एलजीआईटी, एंड वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ ऑटोमोटिव कंबशन इंजन टेक्नोलॉजी। ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैड अ डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग नेचुरल गैस इंजन। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर कवर आवर लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द सिलेबस, मल्टीपल इंजेक्शन डीजल कंबशन प्रोसेस। सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर presentation we are going to discuss about introduction session of diesel combustion process, then double injection systems or pilot plus main injection systems, as well as we are going to discuss about different multiple injection technologies, then which are the factors affecting combustion process in multiple injection systems, as well as we will also discuss about rate of control like open loop control system, closed loop control systems, and we are also discuss about multiple injection with dead fuel injection system. So these are the basic content of this particular chapters which we will going to discuss in upcoming slides. So introduction of the particular multiple diesel injection systems. In recent years, in new injection systems with electronic control, we all know that right now we have electronic control systems and have been promoted as the future standard in injection system for diesel engines. Right now we have a smooth and effective electronic control systems, and this effective fuel injection systems gives us better fuel efficiency as well as better fuel control and better rate of injections, and it will also help to maintaining fuel economy, which directly correlated to the reduction of CO2. Ultimately our goal is to reduce CO2, NOx and particulate matters in particularly is multiple injection technology. So main and most important thing is that the split injection systems, or we can say that it's a multiple injection system. Remember that split injection and multiple injection is the same, can be considered as the most important aspects of the modern diesel engines and its development of in injection systems. We can say that split injection system is the most effective injection system in modern diesel injection engines. Okay, and in this particular chapter we are also going to discuss about production and optical engines combination to evaluate the effective pilot system, as well as post and pre multiple fuel injection systems and its strategies regarding its performance and emissions. So ultimately we are going to discuss about pilot system, post and pre fuel injection systems, as well as we are going to discuss about multiple fuel injection systems considering diesel fuel injection body. So further, gas-based diesel cars are over 35% more efficient than gasoline engines, but their higher efficiency translate directly converted into 20 to 25% savings of CO2 emission. But most important thing is that NOx and particulate matters from diesel engines are major concern. Means diesel engine have particular NOx emissions and PM emissions comparatively high from gasoline engines. And in order to overcome and to reduce these pollutants in diesel engines, are equipped with the high pressure injection systems and EGR and after treatment devices. As we had discussed in engine downsizing chapters, we are also going to discuss about exhaust gas recirculation systems, and there are various after treatment devices like selective catalyst reductions, then urea reduction systems, as well as lean NOx traps. We had already discussed in previous sessions, and that are the basic technology used in the diesel engines to reduce NOx emissions as well as particulate matters emissions. Okay. In particular, the new generation of high-speed direct injection system, as we know that as a HSDI. This HSDI engines is equipped mostly high-pressure common rail system up to 30 to 180 megapascal, capable of multiple injection. Means we can say that the basic range of the pressure injection is 30 to 180 megapascal in high-pressure direct injection system. In high speed direct injection systems, we can get best efficient fuel spray systems as well as dedicated fuel design in particularly spray formation, as well as high rate of injection while combustion process. Okay, so let us discuss double injection or pilot plus main injection system. Double injection and pilot plus main system is same. As you can say it a double injection system, or you can say it is a pilot plus main injection system. So, what is means? Heat injections were evaluated as a good means to reduce NOx and particulate emissions. So, it is known that small amount of fuel as well as a sufficient fuel air mixture is necessary to reduce food formation. Remember that formation is the very basic outcome of the particular injection system. If we control it, then we can get optimization, then we can get proper optimization in fuel injection system. And any intensified mixture of residual air and combustion gases can help oxidize the food. Here you can see that double injection plus pilot plus main system. Here you can see that in the green injection, you can see that there is a pilot injection, and in blue you can see that there is a main injection system. Okay, there basically there are two types of injectors. First one is the main injectors, and second thing is the auxiliary injectors. So here you can see that in green spray formation there is a pilot injection systems, and in blue injection you can see that there is a main injection process. Begin with these requests were particularly filled using pilot injection system. Here you can see that basically there are two types of injection, main injection and pilot injection. So pilot injection considered as a green injection system. In figure you can see that, and main injection system considered as a blue spray injection system. So in this both injection system mainly allowed to control of the rate of heat release in the first stage of the combustion process and realize a smoother increase of the cylinder pressure with the reduction of combustion noise and NOx. So with the help of double injection or pilot plus main injection system, we can get directly reduction in NOx systems, as well as we can get effective noise reduction, as well as we can get effective cylinder pressure in particularly combustion process. So this is the main advantage of the diesel injection or pilot plus main injection system. We can say that double injection or pilot plus main injection system is difficult to build up, but when we proper optimize it, and after proper optimization we can get better result in this double injection system. Further, in diesel injection system there are split injection schemes, reduce NOx with only minimal increase in smooth emissions, and it did not extend the combustion duration. Here main important thing is the combustion duration, and how can we consider it with reference to crank angle degree. So in pilot plus main injection system we cannot increase, or we are not going to increase combustion duration, as well as in this particular process we are going to decrease soot emission considering the combustion process. So this is the main advantage of the double injection or pilot plus main injection system. Ultimately we can get reduction in NOx and with minimum increase in soot emissions, and ultimately we are not going to change any kind of crank angle degree with respect to combustion duration. Now main important task in double injection system is the injector angle, right? Also we had discussed in second generation engines and first generation engines. Also we had a discussion in wall guided system and spray guided system regarding injector location. Okay, so we have to maintain injector angle. Consider injector angle is the 125 degree regarding pilot plus main, and most important and effective technology is the double injection methodology. We have to calibrate each and every injectors regarding this system, because we are directly using gasoline direct injections or TRDI system, commonly direct injection systems, or we are using only direct injection system in this particular system. So these are the basic two factors of the particular double injection system. First one is the injector angle, so we have to calibrate, and we have to locate this injector at particular angle, like 125 degree, 130 degree, 35 degree, and we have to also look for the glow plug system regarding diesel engines. So in these systems, first one is the injector angle is the necessary things, and second thing is the double injection methodology. As we discussed in previous slides, like how can we split it? Okay, and whenever we are going to split this, we have to look for the quantity of the fuel as well as pressure range of the particular injectors of the body. So we can differentiate it properly considering double injection methodology. So this is it from this lectures. In next lecture, we are going to discuss about different types of direct injection methodology, as well as we are also going to discuss about late fuel injection strategy and how late fuel injection strategy directly affect the injection process regarding in diesel injection multiple combustion process, right? So till date, stay home and thank you.